but I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act.
For those he foreknew, he also predestined.
Later, when the man was captured, they got the gun and took it to the testing range, and it immediately fired.
Single parents struggling to make ends meet. For if you are, you belong to us, and you belong to Christ. Christ is the host here today. Christ sets this table, and Christ welcomes all.
Have you been laid off? Does your life seem flat? Are you disabled? Have you been a victim of abuse or violence? Are you homeless? Well, if you are, then you belong to us because you belong to Christ. Christ is the host here today, and Christ sets this table and welcomes all.
With the community of faith? Are you a regular here, full of faith and enthusiasm for this parish? Well, if you are, then you belong to us because you belong to Christ. If you have been away, you can come back. If you have been living in darkness, you can come to the light. If you have not been able to believe without seeing, then just take a look around you. The body of Christ has come here today. Everyone is welcome to Christ, our Lord and our God indeed. Let us all celebrate. Let us all come to Christ. Please let us all stand and sing together, all is ready, page 9.
Is it?
Yes, yes.
Good morning, Father.
Good morning. It's good to be here with you. We are called by God to bring the message to the world, and it's fitting that we should be out here today on this beautiful summer day. As traffic goes by, that we are proclaiming publicly our faith in the Lord and come to be instructed by Him and come to be fed. We pray as always under the sign of the cross in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
In today's reading, we hear a conversation between God and King Solomon. Imagine that God says to you, ask something of me and I will give it to you. What would you ask for? Let us calm our minds to hear Solomon's response and then ask God to show us what we need today to become men and women that we are called to be.
Lord Jesus, you came to show us the kingdom of God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are wisdom made perfect. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you reveal to us the hidden treasures of our hearts. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us all and forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray silently for a moment in our hearts. To the Gloria as found on page 10.
Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God, glory to God and on earth. Peace to people of the wind.
Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest.
Glory to God in the earth, peace to people of the good.
almighty, ever-living God, who consecrated the first fruits of your apostles by the blood of St. James, grant, we pray, that your church may be strengthened by his confession of faith and constantly sustained by his protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Proclamation from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord my God, you have made me your servant, king to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now. And after you, there will come no one to equal you." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
proclamation from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to His purpose. For those He foreknew, He also predestined to be conformed to the image of His Son, so that He might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those He predestined, He also called. And those He called, He also justified. And those He justified, He also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sisters and brothers, the Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to the tradition of Matthew.
Glory to the Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again. And out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys the field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they haul it to shore and sit down and put what is good into buckets. What is bad, they throw away. Thus it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Do you understand these things?" They answered, "Yes." He replied, then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old. The Gospel of our Lord. Understand all these things? And they answered, yes. I hope that can be said of the crowd here. The Lord calls us to be spiritual people who come to understand ourselves, our world, and what is truly important for us. Jesus uses the image of someone who finds the treasure in the field. If we find something really valuable, it captures all of our attention. We're out scuba diving and found a sunken galleon from the early colonial age and thought this might be full of gold. We would be rather consumed by that and get together a group of people to try to raise up the boat. These images call us to reflect on the fact that the Lord calls us not just to spend a little bit of time on Sunday morning, or to say we were raised Catholic, but really to be able to say God is central to my life. And that, my brothers and sisters, is always a process. I recall a couple that I've known for a number of years. He was a homicide cop in Detroit. Now, if you want to have a dangerous job, that's a dangerous job, and he did at times succumb to the pressures of it, and indeed he had some difficulty with his marriage, but he had married a Catholic woman of great faith, and despite their difficulties, she kept
calling him to be transformed. And indeed, as time went on, he became Catholic and they became married in the church. And as that happened, he gave himself to the Lord, and he realized that as he prayed for protection for himself on the job, that he had been saved from death multiple times. Once when somebody attempted to shoot him at point blank range and the gun did not go off. And later, when the man was captured, they got the gun and took it to the testing range and it immediately fired. He knew that God had been watching over him. And later, when he had his thumb shot off, the police said, "You can't be on active duty, obviously." But he was still a fairly young man. And they put him in charge of the police athletic league to deal with troubled youth. God had given him a ministry, and he literally touched thousands of children and young people. And his wife became head of religious education for the parish, and their house was always filled with teenagers. When we put God in charge of our life, despite difficult circumstances, He'll always lead us through. And what we come to need to know is that it does not matter who we are or where we are, if we give ourselves over, we can become transformed. And that process is one that we reflect on today within the life of James, the apostle, the patron of this parish, who, when he met Jesus, gave everything up and said, "This is a man of God who will transform this world. I know it." But he himself had mixed motivations, and later on, his mother would ask Jesus, "And my two sons sit on your right hand and left when you come into the kingdom." She said, "You don't know what you're asking. Can you drink of the cup that I'm going to drink of?" Said, "Yes, we can." And I'm sure they had little idea of what that meant. But somewhere inside of him, he did turn around and give himself truly to Jesus, and not just for self-interest. And James became the first of the apostles to hand his life over. See, when we come to follow the Lord, the spiritual journey that we go on might be like James, and our life changes and our place changes, what we're doing changes. Or it might be like the couple in my parish back in Detroit, that the external did not change, but how they ministered became entirely different. still was a cop, but he was a person who changed lives. And Glenda was still a mom, but she was one that brought not only her own children, but the children of the church to come to know Jesus. And it's not surprising that last Saturday, one of their sons became a Capuchin, took vows. Because they had been transformed from the inside out. They came to know where the treasure was in their life and were willing to hand everything over in order to be able to change themselves. We thank the Lord for those opportunities. We thank the Lord for, once again, St. James sending a number of young people out to minister. And I'm sure they have been changed by following the Lord and by serving the people that they serve. We thank you for that. We ask that we all might come to be refreshed and renewed on our journey of coming to know and follow Christ Jesus. Amen.
Mission to come forward, and I don't know how Brian does it. This is the second one in like months. He's got to be worn out. So, come on, don't be ashamed. Come on up here. Nobody's gonna bite you. Maybe Brian will, but
wait a second. I'm not biting anybody. I ask that people who are here from the first week of mission trip to come up as well. You might see the pink shirts. Whoever has made one of the three mission trips, please come up. We wanna honor everyone who went on a mission trip. And yes, it is true, Father. They have been transformed. There is no question about it. They have thrown down some seed, and there is some rich soil that has taken root. And we, as we always do, thank you for your support in building and growing each and every one of these young people to experience a week of service, but a transformation of their faith and their lives. And I know that several have been transformed already, and some are still working on it, and some we will never see the transformation, but there are many, many good things that happened on mission trip this year in Leech Lake, in St. Louis, in Moore, Oklahoma, and we are grateful that you have answered the call. We are grateful that you have come forward to serve the Lord. So we have two people who are going to speak about the Leech Lake experience, which is Anna and Thomas. If you guys could come forward, please. Okay. And just to talk a little bit about what happened with them. So, Thomas.
Well, one of the first experiences I had in Leech Lake was seeing what Leech Lake really had to offer. And the first thing I saw was boarded up houses, clothes stores, very poor hood, very poor community that we first entered. And so, one of the stories that I had was I was asked once to help drop off the kids that we were helping out, and I saw a house that was particularly bent and busted and broken, and I started saying, "Wow, man, that house is," and then the person next to me hushed me. And as I noticed we were getting close to the house, I realized that one of the kids actually lived in that house. So definitely one of the things but I'm just grateful for the things that we have now. We are definitely very, very well off.
One of the things I learned this week is that most of these kids don't get a lot of food, so they get like one meal a day. So I think I learned that we're grateful for all the food we have, and yeah.
Okay, well, thank you so much for being a part of Mission Trip. We had about 100 young people between St. James, Good Shepherd, St. Mary, and a whole bunch of different churches in the area. And once again, we are grateful for your support. We are grateful for the blessing that you have been for each and every one of us as young people and adult leaders. And thank you so much for providing a great experience for each and every one of these young people.
I think we owe Brian a big great thanks for him going along and organizing this stuff.
We need to be able to have that dialogue between word and action, and that is supported by prayer, and that the prayer relies on what we've come to receive in faith. So let us stand and profess our faith now. I believe,
Father the Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. And from there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
We never know what life will bring us, but we know who can always help us. We pray for ourselves and for each other and for the wider world, that the Lord might come to bless us and work through all of us.
Our response today is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, for what we need in order to live as Jesus would, to serve as Jesus would, and to love as Jesus would. We pray, Lord, hear our prayer. For world peace in Afghanistan, the Middle East, Ukraine, and for all missionaries and diplomats who are committed to finding peaceful solutions to all conflicts. We pray, Lord, hear our prayer. For children coming to this country to escape violence and poverty and seeking freedom, love, and understanding. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those for whom we are concerned, for those who are anxious about their health, or unemployed, or struggling in their marriage, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of every nation suffering due to disasters, wildfires, or flooding, or other natural disasters, may they experience the treasure of seeing Jesus in the helping hands of others, we pray. For all of us gathered here in love today, for our friends from St. Martin de Porres and our safely returning mission trippers, may we all go forth to transform the world, recognizing Jesus in the faces of those whom we encounter this week. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, for those living with arthritis,
heart disease, cancer, diabetes, and other chronic conditions. For Father Mike and all those in our community and our family who have asked for our prayers, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those signed in our Book of Life, for Bernice Boxrucker, who recently died, and for the people of St. James and St. Martin de Porres, for whom this Eucharist is offered, we pray.
God of heaven and earth, look into our hearts to see our needs. Help us to be transformed by your grace. And help us to be a vehicle of grace for others. As we pray through Christ our Lord.
Please join in singing our presentation song found there in your order of worship, I Will Be the Vine.
sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. So be it. Cleanse us, Lord, by the saving baptism of your Son's passion, so that on the feast of St. James, whom you will to be first among the apostles to drink of Christ's chalice of suffering, we may offer a sacrifice pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts.
We lift them up, Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those whom you have appointed as shepherds to lead it in the name of your Son. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. We pray, sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and given you thanks, blessed it, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We celebrate the memorial of Christ's death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the cup of salvation. giving thanks that you have called us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jerome and Donald, our bishops, with all the clergy and faithful. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and to all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. James, St. Bartholomew Porres, with all the saints who pleased you through the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and glory, now and forever. Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be always with you
and with your spirit, and let us share with one another a sign.
ask those taking communion to the homebound to please come forward. Send forth our Eucharistic ministers who literally are bringing Christ to those who are homebound. We ask that all of us come in our own way this week to bring Christ to someone, that we might see ourselves as people who, having been filled with the Spirit of God here, come to share it. It's the insight that James had. Decided he needed to do more than go fishing. But knowing that sometimes it is when we go fishing. It's coming to be aware that the treasure is within us and we distribute it as God inspires us, whenever, wherever, that the Lord might use us and that we might find protection and inspiration and joy in the Lord. Help us, Lord, we pray, that through the intercession of the blessed Apostle James, on whose feast day we have received with joy your holy gifts, may we continue to be blessed through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Now, our announcements this weekend. The robotics blood drive is here at St. James on Monday. Please consider donating. The deadline to register for the Frank Warner Memorial Golf Outing is Monday. Please call the office to register. Even if you don't golf, you can still join. Join us for dinner, please. Regarding Mass on the Grass, there is still time to get in on the big cash drawing. Raffle tickets can still be purchased up until the drawing, which will take place at 1 p.m. Thank you.
And you will want to stick around after you get your brat, because we have two of our very good groups that are going to be performing some of the songs from the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s to provide that joy and entertainment.
The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God be upon us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. We go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our life and becoming a better version of ourselves.
Thanks be to God.
Now, in the past, we've let you go right here. Today, we're going to do something a little bit different. Everybody runs over to get food. We never have a time for a blessing of the food. So today we're going to take that time here before we let you go. And before I also let you go, I'd like to ask you if you would please let our guests from St. Martin de Porres be the first in line. We always let our guests go first. So.
Let us bow our heads as we pray our video blessing. Gracious God, we gather as family and friends among the blossoms and bees, the boughs and the branches, the beauty and the bounty of your creative goodness. Give us eyes and ears to recognize your glory and the splendor that surrounds us, in the vast landscape and the small veined leaf, in the waters, waves, and wasps' warnings, in the crazed squirrel and the crow's squeaking. As we spread our cloth on this sacred earth and lay out our sample feast, give us hearts of gratitude for the blessings of nature and nourishment. And please, God, let us not begrudge the dear ants that wish to share our meal, for they too serve you and praise you. Amen.
And so let us go forth and make a difference in the world.
Amen.